You've said repeatedly that you think that some of the equipment that governors are requesting, they don't actually need. You said New York might need, not need 30,000. You said it on Sean Hannity's Fox News. You said that you might.
Why don't you people act? Let me ask you.
You said some state.
Why don't you act in a little more positive? It's always trying to get you.
My question to you is.
Get you. And you know what? That's why nobody trusts the media anymore.
My question to you is, how is that going to impact?
Excuse me, you didn't hear me. That's why you used to work for the Times and now you work for somebody else. Look, let me tell you something. Be nice. Don't
be threatening.
Don't be threatening. Be nice. Go
ahead. My question is, how is that going to impact how you fill these orders for ventilators or for masks? Your views that it's not going to impact you at all.
We're producing tremendous numbers of ventilators. We're doing a great job on it. Mike Pence, our vice president, has headed up the task force, which has been incredible, the job they've done. We have everybody in the White House working on it. We have everybody in the country is working on this in one way or the other. The fact is, we've done a great job of delivering. You've seen the biggest people in the business. I mean, there's nobody even close to this group of people. We had a meeting at 3 o'clock. It lasted for a long time. It was a great meeting with the generals and with everybody else, and they have done a fantastic job. I'm just saying this. If they're holding, let me give you one example. We sent thousands of generators to New York. They were put into a warehouse, a New York warehouse that happened to be located, interestingly, in Edison, New Jersey. They were given to New York, and we then went to other places, also giving thousands of ventilators. The people in New York never distributed the generators. We said, why didn't you distribute them? Now, you have to understand, they have New York people working in those warehouses. They knew they had them. So we said, why didn't you distribute them? I hope they've distributed them now, but maybe they didn't need them so badly. But just so you know, we're all, you, me, everybody, we're all on the same team. You know, when journalists get up, and you're a journalist, a fine journalist, when journalists get up
Sean Hannity
and ask questions that are so threatening.
I was quoting you directly from your interview with Sean Hannity.
Take a look at my interview. What I want to do is, if there is something wrong, we have to get to the bottom of it. When I hear face masks go from 10,000 to 300,000 and they constantly need more, and the biggest man in the business is, like, shocked. He knows all about the virus, by the way. He's not surprised by that. He knows all about it. He shouldn't be surprised. He should say, well, that's standard, because this is really a very tough disease. This is really a very tough virus to handle. Okay.
Mr. President, my second question.
That's not fair to your other reporters. It's not fair. You had a long time, a long question. If we have time, I'll get back to you for your second question. Is that okay? All right. Thank you. I appreciate it. Go ahead.
Thank you, sir. I do have a question for you, but I'd like to let my colleague Gimish finish her second question, if that's all right.
Go ahead.
Thanks, Jeremy.
I was going to call on you next. You know that.
Thank you, Mr. President. You've also said that at one point that you thought more people might die from the economic tragedies and the economic problems in America due to the coronavirus outbreak. What health officials are telling you that? And Dr. Fauci, could you speak to that, the idea that there might be mental health and suicide related to this? Would that outpace at some point the virus's impact on this society?
Well, I could ask Dr. Fauci to come up, but it's common sense. You're going to have massive depression, meaning mental depression. You're going to have depression in the economy also. But you're going to have mental depression for people. You're going to have large numbers of suicides. Take a look at what happens in a really horrible recession or worse. So you're going to have tremendous suicides. But you know what you're going to have more than anything else? Drug addiction. You will see drugs being used like nobody's ever used them before, and people are going to be dying all over the place from drug addiction, because you would have people that had a wonderful job at a restaurant or even owned a restaurant. I spoke to great people today that have done a great job, and one day, they're at the top of their business, they're celebrity chefs, they've got the most successful restaurants, and in one day, they have nothing. They've gotten wiped out. One day. From our enemy, this invisible, horrible scourge. So when you ask me that, it's so easy to figure that. I mean, massive drug use, massive depression, mental depression, massive numbers of suicide. Anxiety causes, you know, disease, they say. A lot of people, you're going to have tremendous. And hopefully we're not going to have that, because hopefully, by what we're doing, we get the best of both worlds. We don't have 2.2 million deaths. We have a number that's much less, much, much less. And at the same time, we get our country running again. Please. Thank you,
Mr. President.
You were next. He was very nice in doing it, though, nevertheless. Go ahead.
Thank you,
which
sir.
Which is unusual for CNN.
two quick questions. First of all, during this 30-day additional period, do you anticipate at all relaxing those restrictions by region during these additional 30 days?
I don't think so. It's a great question, actually. I don't think so. And I asked that the same. I said, how about Nebraska? How about Idaho? How about Iowa? And you know what? Those people are so great, the whole Midwest. I don't think they want to be in that position, actually. And probably, I was getting a pretty strong look by these two people. They said, we don't like that idea. So, you know, we're relying on them. They're the best in their profession, and they didn't like the idea.
And secondly, sir, I want to ask you about
some comments. And we could do it, but I don't think it would be good.
Thank you, sir. I'd also like to ask you about some comments you made on Friday. You were talking about governors of different states, and you said, I want them to be appreciative. You also said, if they don't treat you right,
I
don't
that.
Call. These are direct,
no,
direct quotes, sir.
Excuse me. Ready? Take a look at what I said. I want them to be appreciative of me, okay? And then you cut it off because it's fake news.
You and of your administration,
listen,
absolutely.
Please, let me just finish it. You just said it again, and you know the answer is a lie. You know that
I could read you your full comments, sir.
Let me just say, look, your statement and your response and your answer is a lie, because here's the story. You ready? I said I want you to be appreciative of me, and then you go on, and then I go on, and you cut it off. But it says because when you're not,
I want them to be appreciative. I don't want them to say things that aren't true. I want them to be appreciative. We've done a great job, and I'm not talking about me. I'm talking about Mike Pence, the task force. I'm talking about FEMA, the Army Corps of Engineers.
Thank you.
But then you went on to say, if they don't treat you right, I don't call. He's a different type of person.
I don't call.
Referring to
the
vice president.
No, I don't call. No, I don't call the governor of Washington.
Why in this time?
But Mike Pence calls, and the head of FEMA calls. I don't stop them. Did I ever ask you to do anything negative, Mike, to Washington, the state of Washington? Michigan, I love that state. That's one of my favorite places in the whole world, Michigan. And I'm so proud of what's happened with the auto industry. It's coming back to Michigan. No, I don't have to call because I'm probably better off not, because we don't get, he's a failed presidential candidate. He's a nasty person. I don't like the governor of Washington. So you know who calls? I get Mike Pence to call. I get the head of FEMA to call. I get the admiral to call. But what you didn't say, see, you started it off and you talked about I have to be appreciated. But then, when you read the rest, it said, because if you don't appreciate, you're not respecting these incredible people, the two admirals, you're not appreciating FEMA and the Army Corps of Engineers who built 2,900 beds in 3.5 days, and you're not appreciating all of the work that's been done, and you're not appreciating these incredible people from private enterprise that are delivering things in numbers that nobody's ever seen. See, and that's why people aren't watching CNN very much anymore. That's why they don't like it. That's why your ratings are no good. Because you, even after knowing the truth for days now, you bring up the old lie. Read the rest of your question, the rest of your statement, you didn't put in. You have to put that in. And it said in there FEMA, and it said in there Army Corps of Engineers, because when they disrespect me, they're disrespecting our government. And you know what? I don't mind if I'm disrespected, but they can't disrespect the Army Corps of Engineers and FEMA. Okay.
Why is the lack of appreciation?
Please go ahead. I want them to appreciate the incredible job we're doing. We are doing a job the likes of which has never been done before. And there are a couple of people that know that. But for political reasons, let's say they're Democrats, they don't want to give this administration credit. And that's okay. But I don't have to deal with them. But our vice president does deal with them. Please, go ahead.
Thank you, Mr.
But that's
President.
Why CNN is not trusted anymore. They are not trusted. They are fake news. Remember that. Go ahead.